Welcome everyone to this live stream. Check. As per popular demand, more Linux tinkering. So back here with our AMD Ryzen that you have seen in our previous videos. The build, mini ITX build and graphic card installation. And here you see we have this DVI connected also to this display. Booting. Okay, don't have a keyboard on there, but I will show you in a second for this, because so this is a short video live stream as per popular demand, more Linux stuff. So you see after the booting graphic disappears, that is because we boot you with some special parameters that I will show you in a second. And for the reason of PCI pass-through, PCI pass-through meaning with virtualization that you can pass PCI devices to virtual machines. Previously you would have everything emulated or virtualized, like a virtual sound blaster and stuff, virtual graphic card of course always. And wrong button. What this means is that we can now nowadays with an IOMMU, and this pass-through requires an IOMMU. IOMMU meaning previously historically we had an MMU, memory management unit, for memory protection to mark pages, like areas of memory, as read, write or executable, and obviously uses for protection in memory protection user kernel space. And let me just type in here a password for IP address 201. 1 second, maybe, like, where's even do we have? And because we cannot just pass through PCI devices without this IOMMU, IOMMU standing for IO memory management unit, and this is required if we would just pass PCI devices. So this would have been possible historically, like forever, but it was not implemented and not used for a decade or two, because if, well, actually more like one decade, not two decades probably, because if we would pass without an IOMMU, if we would pass a PCI device like this AMD GPU in there, Radeon, whatever that was, 560 or something, because we are cheapskates. So without an IOMMU, if we would pass a PCI device to a virtual machine, it could do DMA, direct memory access, to any other region of memory. And this would of course circumvent the virtualization memory separation. So yeah, additionally of key plus passphrase for double security, right? And so at least I hope. Anyway, this is internal, just in precaution not to have here, have us in general be sensitive here and not live stream passwords out as much as we can avoid it. And so without this, if without an IOMMU, and maybe this is possible, maybe there is a option to pass through like dangerous force, I know what I'm doing. Maybe I think I saw something like this. So without this, if you would have had to implement all the mapping of memory addresses and administrative management code glue around this. Long story short, you only want to do this, and with an IOMMU, all the modern Intel and AMD devices usually have an IOMMU. And the only drawback is that, let's switch here to probably this scene here. The only showstopper and issue with this is that not all machines have IOMMU groups in a reasonable way. So, by the way, a little bit too much nearly sunshine here, and maybe actually not too much candelas here. Need to light more candles in my display. So IOMMUs are visible here in this, what was it even, class IOMMU or something, and this is AMD IOMMU, as you see here. And there are somewhere are the groups visible, wherever that was. And you get the idea, somewhere you get a list of I/O groups here. Somehow this is not really what I remembered, or is it? Where are the groups? Somewhere are the groups, wherever the groups are. There are some shell script loops out in the internet. Maybe the groups are also in the PCI device structure here. IOMMU groups. Not sure if in the meantime the LSPCI has a nice listing for this. Maybe not, the last time I checked it didn't. And you would always think that commands have a nice listing for what directory, what? And this is not, could be so simple if it wouldn't. Whatever, you see there are proc devices, you can iterate this. Because the thing is, in this IOMMU, you can only pass or group for access rights devices that are in one group. For example, on this machine, it is thankfully nicely grouped. That many devices are single groups on this ASUS or what this was motherboard. So it depends on the motherboard implementation. I'm not sure if you can edit this. Maybe you can edit this in the BIOS tables, maybe not. Your mileage may vary. Maybe leave us in the comments below if you can tweak this, because the problem is on the Mac Mini that we are live streaming from, it only has two groups, the iGPU, the Intel GPU in one group, and all the rest of the devices in another group. This might mean that if we would plug in a external GPU with Thunderbolt into the Mac Mini, we might not be able to isolate it, because it looked on the first glance that the Thunderbolt controllers are all in the same group as all the other devices in audio and stuff. So you can only pass the whole group because only the whole group shares the same access rights. So then you would need to pass all of those groups in one IOMMU group down to the guest, which is often not what you want. So how do you need to boot? Let's see. I probably have to mount this, because I think I usually have not mounted this EFI thing. So how do we need to boot? And this is only a quick summary, because Danny asked for more live streams. Otherwise, I might have gone out now and enjoy the sunshine. So we need to boot here with Vesar, Video Vesar FB. By the way, is there anything top secret in here? I hope not. Vesar FB and EFI FB off. Otherwise, if you do not disable this, you have it harder to rebind and disable this PCI devices. It's much easier, it's less fiddling around if you already disable this. So Vesar FB frame buffer and EFI frame buffer off. And then additionally, you need to reserve those PCI devices. And I do this here in maybe conf hardware with mod probe. So there is some virtual, whatever that was, IO. And this is for user space as access to devices like PCI. And as I said, this is IOMMU groups in this particular case, because the AMD GPU has two PCI devices. Maybe this is kind of multifunction or something, because it's graphic card and audio for the HDMI audio. So we need to use both. They are both on one PCIe card, and they are both for this reason on the same PCIe IOMMU group. So we only can pass them together. As I said, the whole group needs to be passed down. So these are the PCI devices for this Radeon RX 560D, this Chinese crap variant with two less compute units, cheap crap that we buy here as cheapskates. And then you also need, there was also something strange, so you need this. These are this kernel modules that QEMU needs here for this pass down. Somehow I didn't want to pass this down. Maybe this allow unsafe interrupts was needed for some stupid nonsense if QEMU tells you can't do this because permission denied of whatever. Just take a look in your VMask. So as you have seen, we have here right now black video output, only a static, if maybe visible on screen, maybe not one static. Also maybe it would help if we not only focused but also switch to the full camera view. So the output there has not changed since booting because we disabled this in Linux and it doesn't even focus on this one little cursor spot there. Hello, can you? What kind of focus mode are we in? Even more manual focus or... Ah, no. So this single cursor is from Grub and it didn't change since booting Linux for this frame buffer disabled reasons, obviously. And the command to start this QEMU virtual machine I still have here in the history because I was just fiddling around with this the last week and stuff, all the fun stuff you need to test around if you want to make use of this kind of stuff. So I have here services virtual machines, I have here some test stuff laying around, and on my particular system to run QEMU, QEMU with this PCI passed down there is this long stuff, and I'm still fiddling around with this, not yet fully done. If you have tips with this, let me know in the comments below, because I'm not yet done. And what this allows is, of course, this allows high performance graphic, obviously, if you pass down the whole GPU. So if you have a bigger board with four GPUs, you can pass one GPU down to Windows, another to macOS. And obviously, what can we do with this high performance graphic and even Hackintosh, like Hackintosh macOS Darwin virtual machine with a dedicated graphic card for native performance macOS running in a Linux virtual machine, obviously, because we can't buy Macs anymore. So right now I need this no graphics. I think somehow this, so you see, even though I spent already multiple hours getting all the stuff together, first time testing, you know, all the learning curve and such, and some of the stuff is of course performance optimization there, like SMP 8 cores, threads to sockets, not yet optimal, still working on this, quite some 24 gigabyte memory. Of course, all of this is not PCI path-through related. And then the next thing is here, this is then the path-through here. Sorry for, by the way, are we still hopefully 119 drop frames. Then comes the PCI path-through, the dash device, this VF, IO PCI host, then this is a PCI device in the slot and such for the graphic card, multifunction on, XVGA on, ROM bar 0. I think I googled the stuff together. Most of the stuff you probably need if you have experience with this. Maybe leave me in the comments below what I could do better, what is needed, what is not. Most of this stuff I googled together because it didn't work. Then one argument, another argument, and so on. Then the second one here is this multifunction for HDMI audio. As I said, you need to pass the whole group down. If there is a more amazing syntax for this, let me know. I wish there would be a device pass down host slot something, but somehow it's not so easy as per usual. Then you need, it is best used with EFI BIOS, which is also nice because we want to do more grub testing on this. So this is why I also went for this. And you can maybe use this with an old-fashioned PCI BIOS, but most internet comments and QEMU documentation suggests to use EFI. So we have here this EDK, whatever that is, this Intel reference Theano core EDK to EFI something. You get the idea, downloaded this, was a little bit uncomfortable. I also built this in the past from source for our macOS virtualization. But yeah, Theano core, EDK2, stuff from Intel, you name it. I grabbed the official release, slightly uncomfortable, was an RPM. So I manually unextracted this RPM. So this lines here are for the BIOS, IFPL flash, format raw, read only for the EFI. Open source EFI flash there. It's not yet working amazingly. Then here's some NIC here, some emulated E1000 Intel on a TAP device for bridge mode for direct access, and then here's some T2 Linux installation, of course virt.io. And if we boot this, this not only should work. So what we will not see is now this was reset here, you see, and on so what is not yet working somehow, it is not yet posting here my, actually, okay, wait a second, it actually was posting, okay, there is no, in, so somehow it was posting, you see the static cursor picture disappeared, but it is not yet showing this EFI BIOS on the actual hardware, still working on this. I think it should work, I guess, no idea why it does not work if you have more experience with this. Also, this is not yet auto booting. So this is still the EFI BIOS here on the command monitor thing. And this is, by the way, how you can on this EFI shell run programs directly somehow, yeah, because we run it manually. So this is not yet amazingly auto booting. This is why we make the live stream. If you have more tips to this, let me know. And this is also how we probably will soon debug and implement more EFI booting stuff. And config file. This is already the config, just a little bit Spectre optimized. So what is not yet working? Not yet working is like posting. By the way, we should switch here to this output because we should have Linux booting output here now. So you see this is now, as you have seen previously, we had the BIOS, then we had the stuck cursor. Now we have here really Linux natively on this display. Not making this up. And if we plug in a keyboard, we can't plug in a keyboard because I did not pass any devices through natively. We could also pass through a USB controller for direct plugging in USB devices there to your guest machine. And now we have high performance graphic if we start an X server, and we also have here this open source Theano Core BIOS for and this is now on IP 109. Does this have test? Maybe not test. Let me just put in another password. And as this is on a bridge device, we have here direct connection, secure shell and everything else to that. And you see when we now run lspci here, we have here all the emulated machine with all the virtualized emulated goodness here, Intel E1000. And here we have directly the VGA compatible path through RX560D and also this HDMI audio device here. So this is, oh, by the way, slightly wonder why is this another, should this, I think it was 2.1 and 2.0 and 2.1 natively, but whatever. The rest is emulated. You see here virtual IO blocks. So this is a complete virtual machine with virtual devices. Not really sure, did I already install enough for X? Maybe not, because I mostly used this for this CLang, Clang Musel full GCC-less builds here on the other video, other live stream. And this is what we have here. So high performance virtual machine thing. We can also undo here some editing. Let's see in Arch test and get X up here and do more stuff with this. So what we will do next with this is, aside our commercial work where we need high performance GPUs next, obviously, but because why else would I spend time with this, also do EFI work and pass through stuff. And what I will for sure try out next is archtest out. What I will try out next or sometime soon is also macOS, because you know I maintained the patches and have macOS running already in QEMU KVM, just never with graphic path through. So if we already still need some Mac development, we can also do this in a virtual machine, obviously, because can't buy this Peatbug and unusable crap hardware stuff there. So this is T2, just usual stuff. I only want to check, not only can we enable TempFS, speed, usually I use size, doesn't really matter much, but whatever. And TempFS, okay, TempFS is on. Also want to check that we are not trying to build with ceiling. So CC is, it is ceiling. For what reason would this, alright, because I edited the package selection template. This is a little bit, this comes from working on so many fronts, and this will probably undo itself, likely, but actually we could also, doesn't even hurt so much. So why did this not come up? This was, by the way, SVN up is always a good thing, because this is quite up to date, amazing. So virtual mouse maybe or something, and then let's see, emerge here some XORs or something, also best without typos. Okay, not installed, so need to figure out, need to emerge some stuff. And also we could, you could make use this in multiple ways if you want to game on Linux and your games don't run in Wine. You can use, don't install this bash. Run games in Windows, emulated, and all the Linux maintenance stuff like amazing maintenance and not random updates. So, I mistyped there. This comes from too much. This is, of course, not GCC, but GNU for glibc. So, run native performance Windows games or near native performance. And obviously, macOS, we will try. Not many people obviously do that. And also, reverse engineering. You can also use this pass-through probably for XORs. What does this want? Do reverse engineering with trapping MMIO tracing writes to the PCI card if you want to reverse engineer NVIDIA or our PowerVR that is waiting, the Kuro 2 PowerVR from Kuro 2 from a decade ago that we have for PowerVR legacy. And stuff, develop your own operating systems, obviously, which we also will continue with. So you see, we have multiple topics. I hope you like that we switch here every day to something else interesting. And this leads over ADM log XOS. What does it want now? XMUU, what is this even? XMUU, what is even that? Mosset's package XMU, where is this even coming from? No such package. What the heck does it want? Here, I still need to update some of the dependencies, not the most up-to-date dependency resolution, because it was not the highest priority. So where is this coming from? Which package is that even? Anyone with good Google Girls in the audience today. XMU, why did this not XMU? No such package. Ah, libxml. I would prefer for my build was broken. Okay, you see some random test emerging stuff there. We also likely because I edited the package. Are we in the background yet? I edited the. No, it still didn't build. What does this one know? XT. Yeah, some broken builds because some random reasons. This comes when you test random stuff here, like ceiling, Clang and Musel and whatnot, and mix everything together. Let's see if we can quickly get X up and running here natively. You see now it's compiling, and I think we are testing compiling stuff with Clang now because I had edited this package selection template there for our new bootstrap in a new sandbox. But when you edit this stuff for one build, and obviously you have it in your source tree. I could of course check it out a second time, but we can also already pretest compiling more with Clang LLVM or Clang Clang, whatever. Maybe leave me as usual, always happy to read comments, and leave in the comments below what you want to correct, how to pronounce it, if you prefer Clang or Clang or whatever. This was XAuth. Let's see what happens now. By the way, do we have something like TVM and Xterm? Maybe not. Former build was broken because random reasons, also whatever. So yeah, plenty of stuff we do. I only do this live stream because the audience earlier asked for more live streams, and we can also just do it if I sit here alone and do the builds, or if you watch, no problem there. And we will continue to build up on this, also more server builds. By the way, random shootout or shout out while we live stream, I realized we talked about multiple times about this Power 8 thing, this tie-in. Maybe leave me in the comments right now or below. So they have indeed sold maybe 11. And what is, did they went down with the price or not? So actually this is with including tax. So if my company buys one of those for testing, we even get 19% back. Umsatzsteuer, Vorabzug stuff. I wanted to ever note that I only later realized this is used hardware. I was not aware of this. I thought this is new hardware. So please be aware we discussed this. As I always said, this was never an advertisement and stuff. Oh, now it wants XAV. Did we have this or not? Build no such package. Lib XAV. This is. Former build was broken. Okay, let's see. This was never a paid advertisement and never any advertisement. This was only because this was discussed on Foronix. So please be aware that this is used hardware as this is listed here. This also explains, I was already wondering why it's so cheap, because for new hardware, this was a little bit too cheap to be true. So used, dusty. And say right here, no warranty on used batteries. However, the hardware has been overhauled and tested by us, and probably they all parts are used but 100% working. I would guess they would have to honor warranty if something is not working, but please be aware this is used. Still wondering, leave me in the comments below if we should get something for testing or not. Let's see what happens now. Do we get X up and maybe not. So much to this pass-through. What is happening now? So you see, this stuff is not always just working, especially if you first try it out. Actually, it looks up and running. Why do we not have output? It should have a HESI outputs. Are we have this on screen? So it has here some mode lines. Does it find an edit of this display? It finds this edit here. This is the correct display, PA241W. Now you have my serial number, enjoy it. Hmm, on which output does this even show this? Why do we not have video? We had video when we... Or could this be true that it has black instead of a checkered pattern? Let's try to... We can't press our xset root not found. Let's emerge xset root. We probably maybe also want to rebuild Mesa. Not really sure if I had LLVM installed the last time I built Mesa here. RADM logs Mesa. Did even abort the last time for some reason. Now this is not very helpful then. And let's display equals colon zero xterm. Oh, it works actually. So this was only black for... I really wonder though. I really thought this should have some checkered pattern, but whatever, maybe they changed this recently and they didn't like this checkered pattern. So next we could actually pass through some USB controller, but for this we would, because actually do not really need it natively, but dynamically unbinding this is not that much fun. But for future macOS and Windows work, we probably would need this for the most easy to use path through there. But there you have it, PCI path through for all your fun and Windows and macOS and whatever work. I hope you enjoyed this and learned something. Probably doesn't make so much sense to live stream here tinkering, passing through USB controllers and stuff, but I think this kind of overview already gives quite some information regarding IOMMU that is required and all the command line stuff you need for this and why you need to boot then with this enabled. Of course, it's slightly easier if you have more than one graphic card, then you don't have to disable your boot graphics there if you have only one. And if you have integrated, by the way, I would have wanted to test this with this Dell XPS, because one thing with this Dell XPS that we tested, the 2-in-1 with AMD graphics, you could, because this was not connected to any display output, you can check out this videos in our video library there. And because with this you could actually, for a mobile high performance workstation for professionals, Dell XPS, path through this Radeon graphics, not use it natively, and use this for virtual machines to have their amazing performance. The only thing you need to do, you need to get the graphics out of there, as it's not connected. You either need to remote desktop VNC or whatever, or fiddle some. There probably is not... Actually, I printed this. From me, not from others. Obviously, you want to watch my videos. So you can't get the graphic out directly out of this Dell XPS. There is 2-in-1 with AMD graphics. Also would help if you would switch to that screen. And for Intel GPU virtualization, there is code to get graphics out of that. But for the dedicated graphic, not what you would need. You would either have some special infrastructure on Linux. I think it's not yet there, but I think there's no infrastructure there, because this PCI device is completely passed through to the guest operating system, so you can't simply get the frame buffer out of there. But I guess theoretically Intel has iGPU, Intel graphic virtualization, iGPU VT or something. But this Intel graphics I could not get to work. I toyed around already multiple times with this Intel GPU virtualization, also ever-changing, hard to get working subject. Maybe today it's easier. I tried this already a year and 2 years ago, again before the major YouTube streaming. Nowadays we would have documented this here, everything. So if you have Intel graphics, you could share this Intel graphics with guest operating systems, and maybe nowadays it is easier and might work. Maybe we try this another video. And what this allows is more controlled virtualized sharing. Then this Linux driver has control over the frame buffer, and you can blitz this out of the guest operating system. This is complete path through like this one. You don't have this. So in case of this laptop, you would either in macOS use a screen sharing, which is using VNC, and on Windows remote desktop or something, or fiddle something yourself, or Google if someone, maybe there is prototype code for this, because ideally we would need something to blit this frame buffer graphics high performance out of the guest VM then, in this case for this Dell XPS, but maybe you find this useful already in some way. And yeah, comments in the audience. The Graver writes he could never get PCI pass through to work because just enabling iOmni causes issues on my old Creative PCI sound card. Okay, I see. Interesting. Yeah, I also saw on some machines like a Microsoft Surface or something, I think I saw some Wi-Fi, PCI Express connected Wi-Fi issues with IOMMU. Usually, of course, these are driver bugs because the driver might access some memory or PCI config space or whatever that is not really there. It'll be fixed in any case. But yeah, even this took me quite some afternoon of tinkering, which is probably better that I didn't live stream this. And as you have seen, what is not yet working is the BIOS post. I would expect this BIOS to be shown on the graphic. This does not yet work for me. If you have tips for this, let me know. Probably I already getting this to work here with all of this kind of commands here was already, the commands are in this one, but anyway, I showed this earlier already. This was quite some hours of Googling and trial and error and rebooting and stuff, but this is what we are here for, this kind of low-level educational content stuff. And what is also upcoming next is PCI low-level coding for our own low-level fun for DOS vintage graphics and own operating system. So don't forget to share, like, and subscribe for that. I probably better do something else now because I have the feeling if I oversaturate the subscribers with massive amounts of live streams, it is not helping and people rather unsubscribe because they get too tired of a flood of live stream. And we will have tonight anyway our weekly news show. So don't forget to share, like, and subscribe and watch out for today's IT news show of this week. And this will be somewhere around 8 or 9 Central European Summertime, which started today. And also we have still to continue with this RME32 Digi 32 card, which I got somewhat working but not yet fully working, and this is also something we need to finish. You see so many things to program, educate, document and stuff. And point being what Denny asked earlier, so I hope you got some inspiration regarding QEMU or QEMU, by the way, names that you can pronounce. My recurring theme here. I hope you learned something in this virtualization department. PCI path through, what it is useful, what you can use it for. Just now that I killed the X term, certainly no X terms there anymore, but we can get it back there. And maybe next I path through the USB controller. Some of this you can, by the way, why are now we have no probably energy saving. And some of those PCI devices you can unbind dynamically in some sysfs file. Maybe we shut down this VM, or actually I probably want to rebuild the latest version of Mesar. We can still, as long as we have people watching, actually continue. Actually, we have already the latest version here. Let's see if this compiles, because we probably, let's see, mine qllvm, is this what llvm? VM 8.0 is probably the latest version. Let's see if we can compile the latest VESA with the latest version of LLVM, even because we switched here temporary to Clang, even compiling MESA with Clang, we can also make the log file visible for the most fun YouTube stuff. So maybe next I try to pass an USB controller down for the testing of it. And unlike the graphics, which is harder to rebind, it is possible to unbind and rebind this regular PCI devices. Just with the graphic it is harder because the PCI device must be unused and you can not as easily, I think, unbind the boot graphics. Unbinding meaning to unload the driver, which with the boot graphic you probably can't do it with Linux or so. At least I couldn't get it to work or not found. And the other drivers like USB controller, probably you can unbind dynamically without reboot, so that you like unbind the currently running XHCI USB 3 driver of Linux and instead attach it to this VFIO virtual user space IO thing there for a more seamless virtual machine starting experience without unbinding and pre-binding this to the VFIO user space access driver thing. And yeah, shortly rebuilding here MESA for the latest 3D stuff just to have it. And this is of course really nice thing for testing. We could even with this stupid, by the way, this thing got super warm. First time I used HDMI audio. We made videos, still need to continue, and there you see so much stuff we have to do. And if I, my recurring theme here, if I would do this for the fun, for the greater good of contributing here something to the world, if I would do all this stuff here, we need to tinker with this stupid bloody binary only driver. We have the RME aided, 8-channel aided card to finish this driver stuff, PCI, new code, microkernel, and if I just continue with this stuff here privately on my own, I would not earn a single cent. And we could make a YouTube streaming virtual machine stuff with this pass-through, passing through an USB 3 controller and the AMD GPU and live stream. You have here one deterministic, non-broken, nicely maintained, stable and such virtual machine just for YouTube live streaming theoretically. And on an additional note with this DVI to USB 3.0 Epiphone thing, again, not the most recommended because binary only driver, which is why we had this old kernel working there with this one binary only driver thing. Also with VGA, it gets warm with this full HD audio connection there with the second camera from the earlier live stream. It got super hot, so not really sure if you want to have this running for 8 hours. Not sure if it's recommended. Not really sure if this, yeah, long-term stability questionable, but I wanted to try the HDMI audio to know if it works with this stupid binary only driver. And additionally, because we might do some fun gaming, like playing DOS games like X-Wing or other stuff, live streaming here at night just for fun and for profit. And I wanted to test if this audio works for that reason. And although the DOS gaming will not be HDMI audio, but maybe P3 or whatever other stuff. And this is why I wanted to check if this audio works. I still wonder how this is modulated though, because this audio worked through, while we wait here, more educational. So DVI does normally not have audio, but HDMI has. This is why the camera is sending audio, digital audio, through this, by the way, micro HDMI cable here. And then this really works here through this HDMI to DVI dongle adapter galore here. And this really works, surprisingly. And I really wonder, I would have thought they have a dedicated pin here for a speed of audio, but it doesn't probably look like this. So somehow they have this HDMI audio modulated there in between the other digital packets on this digital. This is, by the way, differential something. By the way, is this compiling so long? Hello, really compiling so long. We could shortly try to Google this HDMI audio. This is differential signal something, as far as I remember. And by the way, this signal wise, this is the same. This is TMDS, or what was this exactly? Hello, can you also, this was a, we want this here, obviously. Can you also load? Of course, now it loaded the German, slow as it loads slowly. And so this is TMDS, protocol is TMDS, standing for, and by the way, here are, do we have this on screen, that we have here more educational electronic content. Also certainly wants this visible here then somewhere for the greatest YouTube layout. So this are all TMDS and some reserve pins and whatnot, optional Ethernet channel, audio return channel, and here is I2C for DDC, this display data channel, or what that was. So it looks like the audio is actually modulated with packets there in this TMDS. That means that theoretically probably DVI could have audio, yeah, transition minimized differential signaling here. And as I said, differential signaling, not regular ground based zero positive, but differential there as per this diagram, switching entirely between positive and negative for better signal integrity and such. And really wonder how they have then this audio signal there in this. So DVI does commonly not support this, but as you have seen, it works over those pins there. DVI, of course, digital visual interface, and all this fun stuff that few people know how this works. And I showed this earlier already in my Kuro soldering episode, that these are even analog pins here for old-fashioned analog video. This is how this capture thing can have analog capture, VGA capture over those pins, still the display data channel on this display data channel pins, and HDMI obviously over the shared electronically compatible pins of the same TMDS signals there. Just that I wonder how the audio is going over there. So HDMI is a newer digital video audio, and in addition to HDMI lacks the VGA compatibility on the analog signals, no surprise there. And DVI is specification-wise limited. You see the signals are entirely the same, but anyway, nonetheless, although the signals are compatible, DVI is, or was at least, I should probably say, limited to RGB color model, while HDMI also support YCBCR444. This is this TV kind of chroma and luminance stuff. And here, in addition to digital video, HDMI supports the transport of packets used for digital audio. So this is really packeted inside there. This is not just SPDIF, something digital audio, but packets inside there. And this is why with this IO MMU, we need to pass both, because they are this multifunction video and HDMI audio. We need to pass this audio device through there, as you have seen. And yeah, now we compiled, which, well, this was the, so Mesa apparently really compiled here with the latest version of LLVM for the 3D stuff, and maybe compile here XF86 video AMD GPU as even a new version, amazing, but we still don't want the new bash version. Let's also build this for the fun. So DVI can have audio. I have a DVI to HDMI audio, and it carries the sound from out like, for what do you have? I have a DVI to HDMI audio. DVI, what exactly do you mean by this? But yeah, as I said, just said on the specification, DVI was not specified for audio, and audio came with HDMI. So they added this additional packets in between there, and general, I think, at least historically, graphic cards did obviously not support audio on there, as this was not a thing. And let's kill x and start x and xterm and maybe glx gears we don't have. Let's also emerge mesa demos for missing only for the glx gears or so. And yeah, as you see, you can do this. It is electronically signal compatible, and they have chosen not the, although I hate this binary only driver, the thing is in general not the most awful, although it's getting plenty warm. And of course, interesting choice here for this VGA with DVI for also HDMI, including audio. In general, a nice use of standard ports. I really like standard ports, keeping it stupid simple, not a proprietary cable nonsense. Please always do standard conformant port use like this, and then you don't need special cables and adapters and whatnot. And yeah, we can still wait a second for Mesa demos for theoretically maybe to emerge there. Then I can have more fun off camera, I guess. Go for lunch or so, and later start a live stream later tonight for this week's IT news as our weekly recurring theme here. So some GLUT stuff is not there for whatever reason. Where was GLUT coming from? So free GLUT not installed, and I still don't want. Yeah, I still need to fine tune our dependencies, our biggest drawback over other distributions, I guess, mostly automatic versus cache files, what is read during compilation, just that they were not updated in a too long time. Okay, this did not want it to install, but there's also GLUT, right? Or what was it? Oh, also best spelled correctly. Not installed. Let's see if this GLUT works, all the many versions of GLUT and whatnot. So let's see what kind of views did we got the last. Okay, the battery live stream was mildly. Actually, could also do this here on this thing. As usual, leave me in the comments below what is most interesting and what is not. Makes no sense that I live stream here stuff that nobody wants to see. Also, this also failed because bloody GLUT reasons. All the vintage legacy stuff, but whatever. And yeah, I hope you learned something. Plenty of things discussed from IOMMU to PCI pass-through. Just that you heard some terms and know what they are used for. 400 drop frames. Nah. Really wonder why our cable network here is not as amazing as in France. But then again, there we didn't usually stream with moving camera pictures, but mostly with screen capture. Also, not only thank you very much for joining and commenting here, also for all the new subscribers, and because we got some new ones, still celebrating each and every new subscriber here, highly appreciated. We could also check what is the problem with this GLUT stuff here. What does this want? This wants C. This was seriously wants a CSH. Damn it. Which GLUT was this? This was this GLUT, then CSH apparently, because nah, no such shell. Where was CSH in current? CSH was in RTCSH, of course. And what did we got there? TCSH. Yeah, let's see if this is doing something. As usual, we are mostly through. Of course, you can rewind and watch it here in the archived section, but as usual, if you're when we are mostly through and want to stop the most people tune in, actually nearly wants me to try USB path through here directly, because then we could plug in here a USB keyboard and mouse and have your native USB performance. This is why this small Apple keyboard are actually not too bad. A pity they have stopped manufacturing them because of those multiple fit on the desk here. Even if they are not the most amazing, at least they are small. So, TCSH, now let's see, does glut, no, glut still doesn't want to build, yeah, so the usual doesn't find some libraries because not looking into search paths, I guess, nah. Okay, then let's shut down, don't need this mesa demo set desperately, and this is of course only the path through thing there, and then we can see what we need for passing through some USB controller. And the fun thing is often you have more than one USB controller, of course, for multiple of your USB ports, and then you can also pass through just one of them and have native USB keyboard and mouse and guest USB keyboard and mouse if you usually have more than one. You see now we have our virtual machine stuff stopping here, and then we have no signals, so Linux shut it down so that this PCI device now doesn't have signal anymore. Maybe even it is now without power or nearly maybe suspended there, this D3 or something, powerless cold state there. Let's see, Linux IO MMU groups. There should be some shell snippet, maybe somewhere like here or somewhere else. No, not here. And let's iterate this here shortly, maybe here in this Arch Linux thing. MMU groups. As I said, you can only pass them down in one. You see there are a lot of, here is something, IOMMU groups, here is something. So this iterated those, and you see here are the groups that I was talking about. So there are often multiple things in one group here, some multifunction stuff here all in this group. But I think on this machine, I'm lucky that this ASUS mainboard has here all the PCI devices usually in one group. You see group 3, 4, only one device and such, and only this multifunction stuff here. So let's take a look. USB controller here is in group 18. Let's see how many USB controllers do we have here, or is this only one? Let's grab iUSB. No, we have here two USB controller, one USB 3 and the other maybe USB not 3 maybe. So this is of course, normally you would want more of this. And let's see USB 3. Actually, I could check here. We have here quite some ports, so I could actually try to only pass this more old-fashioned maybe down this to something. So this is, I hope this should be, is this, so let's see this LSPCI. LSPCI, grab iUSB, and so this was this one, I think. Wait a second, I click exactly this one, two here. And I wish they would have here more verbose numeric stuff, verbose numeric. So, to something. And this is a device. And yeah, subsystem, whatever. What is which of which is which here? This should be the device vendor ID. And let's see, unbind, does this guide? No, this bind does not have unbind, because the question is now, this unbind stuff is always a little bit, nah. We need to bind, but this will probably not work so easily. This is of course always ULIFE. Ah, damn, I wanted to have this selected. Let's, this was 0 to something should have been. Wait a second, this is not the one I meant. Zero two. Ah, wait a second. This is interesting. Is this not multifunction? Let's iterate those IO MMU groups, not that we need to pass down a serial ADA controller. So 14, 15, you see this are together, VGA and audio are together in this group 15. USB controller 18. And where is the serial ATA thing? Here 14, 14, 14, 14, Ethernet. And where is our USB was? USB C18. So somehow we are lucky, although this is, looks a little bit. Oh, wait a second. Where is our other USB controller? Here, no, wait a second. This. Okay, so then we can't. As you see, this is exactly what I mentioned. We don't even need to try. This 14 is together in this chipset thing there, together with this multifunction stuff. So you can't pass this as a single device. Unfortunately, it's also really stupid that it was implemented like this. You really wonder why they had to do it like this. So really limits the usability of this by a huge deal. So let's see how many are in this group 18. So group 18 is maybe really only this USB 3 controller. So then we can only try with this USB 3 controller, in contrast to what I initially wanted. But there you see how it is, what you need to look up. So USB, this is this. We need the PCI vendor ID, and maybe we copy already the whole slot thing there. So this is what we need. And Linux is there. Here's some how to assign devices, bind and unbind. Let's see what is an RF. Ah. So bind device, unbind. You see, if you do not do this each day, then here's some unbind sudo t, and each, you see, unbind driver. Ah, okay, so this means this looks okay. So you need this whole slot thing here. You need this for unbinding, and then let's see this. This is bus PCI, so echo this thing here, this bus slot and device stuff. By the way, I really wonder, is this all USB 3? Yeah, looks like this. Okay, then, of course, without spaces, if this doesn't pass correctly, it will not, the kernel will not do this. So echo the stuff to bus PCI devices, and then this whole device thing there, probably, again, hello. And then always, this encoding is always different, as you see. And then device is, what device is? Driver. So driver is, should probably be a symlink to the currently driver, like USB 2 driver. Let's see, does this work? No such device. No such device there. There's a fun start. Let's take a look here what this is. So this is this device. By the way, we can double check IO MMU group here is a directory. Fun stuff. But actually here you can see if you go into here IO MMU group and then devices. Yeah, this is only this one device, because I think in here should be all the devices in the IO MMU group. And then you see here the USB ports, and driver is a symlink to, as I said, this is a symlink to XHCI, the USB 2 host controller interface thing. And there you see the fun of unbinding syntax. Oh, by the way, what did we echo in there? We echoed in there. Yeah, this is probably so much to the syntax. It probably needs to be exactly this syntax here. And you see LSPCI list something, no such. Hey, this worked, yay. And then the next thing, so this probably makes our bus here unregistered, as you see, this worked indeed. We can also directly put this here into our startup thing if we wanted to save this already, conf hardware or whatever local boot up stuff you want to put it in here. And for example here, unbind this with this echo for this or echo native English pronunciation here. Let me know in the comments below what is more amazing. And next we need to bind this, so the same thing, this one here we need to echo into, maybe without new line, maybe with, the mileage may vary, echo this into modules V, or do we have drivers also like bus PCI drivers, and then here this user space VFIO PCI bind, also best with no such device or directory. Always the fun stuff of this stuff. There you see, I also wish, maybe leave in the comments below if you wish this stuff would be a little less error prone. We probably need to add this ID here. The question is always the format of this stuff, because this, we need to teach this user space proxy thing there, the device ID we want to use for this. So we need this was slot 9.3. Is some USB controller here, XHCI, yeah, this one. And wait a second, did I? Oh, we need numeric, we need this USB 3. And then people wonder why IT is expensive. Which one was this? No, even 03. Damn it. USB 3. Here's this one, 9.3. Here's this one. So we need this USB vendor product ID. Let's see, can we directly echo this into here, into this new valid argument? Yeah, it could be so easy, but some of the syntax of each and every file, this is really, here's by the way, it wants space. This is of course really ridiculous. This each thing here always wants its own formatting. So let's save this also already. So unbind this, make the new ID visible or known to this, that we want this user space driver virtual proxy thing, bind to this kind of ID here in this bus driver's PCI, and then we need to bind it again, which previously didn't work. No such device. Yeah. Why? We unbinded this exactly with this syntax. Why would this not work? Bind. Can't make this stuff up. You see, unbind worked like this. Bind does not. The fun of Linux proc fs new id bind. Does this automatically bind? I have no idea. Maybe we just try to start it like this with this slot. Let's see what happens, if this magically works or not. Come on. Somehow I doubt it will work, but let's see what happens. So, this format is device, blah, blah, blah. Hmm. Virtual IO stuff here. Oh, wait a second, what is this? Multifunction, blah, blah, blah. We need this non-multifunction stuff. Actually, this doesn't have the vendor product ID, so just 08 something, so 09, maybe like this. Hmm, and it does something. At least it doesn't error out, so somehow maybe the binding was necessary if we were lucky. Then we could theoretically maybe have a keyboard controller, but at least not there yet. Then, okay, this is a serial console like monitor thing here. Oops, wait a second, what is this? Wait a second, which is this now even? You know what this is? Not what I wanted, actually. This is funny. And I found system bus new ID. Yes, this new ID we have done already, thank you. Ah, here's FS1. So now we... So this actually works already, although the keyboard doesn't work here, but... wait a second, do we have... No, we don't have post. So this works already here, this because this is a USB attached thumb drive there. And so now we have the two. So you see this works already. We have the second file system. We already had the bootloader here. Access this. Let's see, does this work? GPT1 grep config? Yeah, it works. So the question is not only since this moved here, this is why usually you don't want. Ah, damn it. As I said in this earlier video, slightly uncomfortable editing here, but ideally we would want. So let's see, this should probably come up, then we can even find ourselves another abundant spare USB mouse like this and have even here first time for myself USB pass through, which we anyway need already one step closer to running macOS in there for obvious hardware reliability, thermal throttling and other amazing reasons. So unfortunately, however, no USB stuff. Where did I? Ah, also helps to plug it in. And we have direct USB pass through here to the virtual machine, as you can see. Live on YouTube. One not major epic fail. For more fun stuff to continue with it. One root password later. Audio back and maybe the camera. Also, yes, sunny in Berlin because summertime. And so there we have this, and let's start X and have here hopefully a mouse cursor. Hey, we have a mouse cursor. So completely low latency, high performance, you name it, only real with TWM. And if we now would have, where's even my mouse cursor? There is it. So yeah, point more underlined here regarding high performance Windows, macOS, you name it. I wish we would have this stupid X demos for Mesa demos for what was here wrong? This was Right, somehow this stuff not finding X stuff because it's not looking in this. Hello, where's my this focus follows mouse stuff. So we probably can work around this. I slightly wonder why this is not workarounded. Let's see in the package. Is it even large enough? We could actually capture this also. But whatever, coffee. Don't forget hydration and caffeine. Glut. Don't we have some workarounds? This, oh my god, this is... Actually, do we still need this? Do we not generically remove this already? We could actually probably try if this is still needed. And we have here actually... Wait a second, link. This is also... Did I not commit this already once? So it's of course a complete garbage package here from back in the day, not even touched in, or no, touched in T2 times. But of course, wait a second, this is even main. This is completely old garbage crap. Why do we have such quality of package in T2? This should be forbidden. Only live here on YouTube, criticizing our own packages. So you should not have, but there you see that some packages are also packaged in a really crappy way that probably for installing, they probably had a wait a second, why is this plus W? Anyway, cleaning up with some permissions for whatever. And so then this 486 should probably be removed. You see people packaging their stuff as 486 and they're, I mean, ridiculous. And then also we want here libdir. Actually, this is not optimal. Let's see, like libdir, and this also should be libdir. Wait a second, then I should not have deleted here all this stuff. Yes, we are still live on YouTube. I call back in a second. And so libglut, you see also using the Samsung, not making that up. So does this look reasonable? Maybe, maybe not. Also, this is also not 100% Welcome, Lars. So this is also, this should be root. Root always for cross-compile prefix and then include dir or so. Include, wait a second, include dir probably, hopefully. And what is this, the whole thing there to root? Include. Also better. So Lars writes, I've been trying to install macOS on QEMU using libvirt a few times, ended up unsuccessfully. I also would like to know if you are my home server is AMD Ryzen 5. And thanks, Python, Bergisch Gladbach. And thanks for this, for liking the live stream. Yes, so we have macOS running. Actually, I can't show it to you because our main, for legal reasons, obviously, our main virtual macOS test thing is there the Mac Mini, if not the aging Mac Pro, obviously. But the Mac Pro is shit and doesn't have an I.O. MMU, old aging crap. And the Mac Mini is right now, we are live streaming from the Mac Mini, so I can't show you that. So that is on for another live stream. And yeah, then we for sure will try this another day, obviously. Also, I need to update the patch set stuff. So in general, I run, by the way, I've not updated this because nobody paid me. Why should I voluntarily waste this hours of time for Silicon Valley startups who only pay us when they want something? Certainly not do this voluntarily. Those stupid glut packages are needed from all this old-fashioned stuff. Always better not to make so many edits here. Also, I also usually like here some group formatting, so this would be slightly nicer. Even nicer would be to get rid of the stupid main function. This is violating all the T2 stuff. We, for some light editing, let's make this here step by step without huge rewritings. Besides, this is some old crap, not even sure if it's the right package. And this could probably be already libdir. I mean, I say not too much, but then I see this is script, this is script. This should be libdir for so many reasons, include, oh, this is also libdir. Now I start editing everything again. What I see is so broken and wrong. Damn it. Yeah, maybe it doesn't need a slash here. Maybe this results in a double slash. Maybe we will see in the log. So the main thing is it was not finding, let's save this already. It was not finding X stuff. So let's, although I thought it should probably, let's take a look in the log file for a second. And by the way, you see, I can also edit with Xterminate TWM. No crazy window manager stuff and needed. No 3D wobbling windows and whatnot. So we do here some automatic transforms, but only if it is there to transform it. Okay. Then let's make here var append GCC wrapper insert to library dir like root user x11. Okay, theoretically, damn it, this is okay. So we need the multilib lib64. So shortcut for this is libdir everything removed from. So remove from the front is this. Of course, English keyboard here right now. Everything until the slash should leave us with libdir. Maybe we make here set X for some quick tracing to verify that our variable expansion stuff is correct there and emerge this again. So yeah, nice that we have people in the audience, that people like it, that we have here topics. Again, various topics for various reasons, various people, various stuff. We need this new high performance stuff. We need GPU pass through. And wait a second, this is no syntax error. This failed quickly in 939, which is what? Maybe here some quote missing. Ah, come on, where is here? And so much stuff to do. So our, you don't need to worry that we run out of ideas. We can disassemble our analog watches, tune here guitar strings and make your PCI path through. And why does this not build clot now? This is not what? Okay, let's force it for whatever reason this didn't build. So we have here indeed adding not what we wanted. This is why I had this tracing there. What have I mistyped now? Libdir. This is of course one there too many. Why did nobody scream there? What do I have, you guys? So there, see, okay, this is not a, let's see, 11x, wait a second, this did not remove user lib as I wanted for, why, this is a star missing. Maybe I actually probably wanted to type a star there. So of course star slash. So you see what this tracing is good for. So now we have here indeed lab. I have this here dynamically for the most future-proof compatibility with all the multilib stuff, of course, old-fashioned crap packages, so whatever. And probably we can suspend this here background and less the log file, because we should have here generically, yeah, we remove arch mcpu stars. So what did we remove there? Just no xorg glut, or then did also, did you mean we actually really indeed need this. You see it's really still hard coded in there. What bloody nonsense. Vi, or do we, no, we don't have. You see what people hard code in their packages. Why would someone hard code that in there? I have no idea. So this line is really needed there. Did not expect this, actually, after a decade or two. Let's try again. And also to document count stresses often enough, all the time spent on running open source and what our $3 YouTube AdSense is here for. Otherwise, I would sit here alone and earn nothing, and people would only write me emails what doesn't work without wanting to pay me to fix it. Because, of course, I should do this here on each Saturday and Sunday and night and evening, and what else not, lunch break, holiday, you name it. And also, of course, really nice setup to play with other distributions. Say if I wanted to test Fedora or Debian, Ubuntu, whatsoever, if not probably Haiku and so on for BOS success or fame. And of course this still doesn't error, but it is only, okay, this is only top level directory. So now we have installed here probably with our last minute tinkering here something in some stupid directory like, this is by the way why I usually prefer in packages to have here verbose. Actually, okay, this was verbose. So what have we done here? Probably here some libdir stuff. What have we mixed up here in our lib here? This here is a, this is of course libdir, not lib. What lib? Too much talking. What do I miss up here now? Lib. This is complete nonsense what I typed here. Why did nobody call this out earlier? What do I have you in the audience if not for proofreading? Uninstall glut to get rid of this top level files, because otherwise we might get the same error again if this is still in the package metadata ASCII database file there. We probably do not remove this M64 there. We use CV generically remove obviously all the CPU and stuff, not to have the hard codings for 486 or whatever, but this M464, the super old fashioned architecture optimization specification from GCC 2.95 or whatever that was, because we probably need dash M16, 64, 32 and whatever. This is probably why we can't automatically remove that. Although maybe we could remove three letter digit stuff like this, but for one in 5,000 old-fashioned packages, probably not worth to remove this globally. So probably we could actually double check the package F-list if we would be outstanding maintainers to check where this actually is going here. Of course, not the most amazing header setup, but whatever. For now, that probably is good enough here. Actually compile. No idea why that was broken so long. Andreas Baumann, the terminal is really hard to read. Maybe make it full screen. Yeah, that doesn't make it larger though. Could only zoom more in. Sorry for the probably the best live streams at night for better contrast ratio there. Comes for streaming here a day without curtains in the office. Yeah, still probably not the most amazing to read. Is this halfway decent sharp? I hope so. And so this is committed. Let's try our amazing Mesa demos again. What are we? Somehow when you cancel this here, then build package, it's not recorded correctly as aborted, as I just find out. And yeah, very nice to see that you like this live stream here and hang around with this. I hope you learned a lot of things here. And of course, this still fails for glut. What do we have even? Do we have glut in there? Libglut.so. Libglut.so. Why does it not find this? Rvar ADM. Logs, Mesa demos, what is now the issue there? I have the feeling though it wanted this other glut. Cannot find glut. Why would it not find it in it is there or not? In user lib64 lib glut.so, or is this somehow some broken stuff, not the right shared object for some there, this is non working, or is it actually could 3737 actually looks like, or is this wait a second, this symlink is wrong to lib without lib, so this is indeed a dead symlink. Thank you for that. Already committed this. Maybe I should have tested this. Ah, here is hard coded. Damn it, why? Maybe you don't want this absolute pass in there. Maybe we should SV and blame and find out who the who did this. I hope it wasn't me though. Maybe just for the fun, if I have to blame myself or not. SV and blame our base or something. Okay, this actually is so old apparently, so this we have just committed. Let's blame here from the new Oslo subversion, blame from, and by the way, subversion I find much more reasonable syntax in contrast to Git. Wow, this code is so old, you will not believe. This is from initial check-in, so this is older than 2000 whatever SVN log revision 1 do we get, so this is older than 2003, so much to legacy. And yeah, so this is from the initial commit when we migrated from maintaining CVS or patch such and such before version control was a thing, when there only mostly was the CVS, this concurrent version control stuff. So I don't even know who to blame. Maybe me, maybe Clifford, maybe some random contributor. By the way, the, this was fun. Was light was focused on some crumbs there. So yeah, so much to code not amazing and partially broken for a decade or two. Let's build this again and see if this works then. It's of course a pity I double checked this stuff and then I committed it's still broken. So much to double checking even more. And again, so much stuff to share and educate here. And yeah, of course, relative symlinks are more amazing than absolute path symlinks. So much more convenient, obviously, and also more compact, require less space on the file system. Some characters less there, not that the path would be so long, but keep it stupid simple. Obviously also super vintage, ugly package. I have the feeling Mesa might ideally want the other gluts, so this other free gluts that also didn't build for other random reasons there. Let's take a look on this log of this free glut though. I have the feeling I recently fixed this, whatever is wrong with this again. Vintage packages of what was the problem here? Ah, this is some Mesa. Yeah, I somehow have the feeling I recently fixed something like this, whatever. Damn it. So let's see our symlinks now. Hey, now they are correct. Then let's build. Let's see. Not really sure if it works with this glut in contrast to the other free glut, but let's see. Otherwise, I fixed a vintage abandon. Not needed package just for the sake of it, but maybe we are surprised in this Mesa GL demo stuff gears. Okay, still doesn't. What is no wrong here? And undefined reference to GLY even. Wait a second, wrong log file. What demos? So many log files here. GLX query something. Okay, whatever. Let's commit this glut thing here. I have the feeling fixed glut SO symlinks, whatever. Not really too interested in this package. Let's deinstall it again because I have the feeling this is some more vintage stuff that is not amazing. We probably want this free glut, so we just wasted all our time here for no good reason. The more vintage packages the better. Maybe I should delete it actually if it not is useful for any stuff. So this header, I really wonder, I had this recently with something else. Let's see if we have some workarounds for this already in FreeGlut. No, we don't have a conf file for that. This is, I'm pretty sure I checked this recently on another live stream for something else in Mesa. Yeah, just that it also doesn't look up probably the include parse, because why should it? Okay, let's copy this fix from glut, not to retype it here again. This insert this here, just slightly different for free glut. And yeah, if I would have the capture thing in here, I could actually capture this, but OBS doesn't like so much this dynamic plugging in of video for Linux devices. Don't want to crash it, already crashes sometimes. So without a conf file here, some light stuff. This is not the most perfect, I just want to get this going. User XF actually, no, wait a second, we can, this is actually relatively universal. Just include here, this should probably usually work, at least for the, of course, best would be to patch this, whatever makefile it is using, to look up the dynamically installed Mesar includes there. Actually, why do we get there some screen flickering? And also for graphic driver development, if you are into Mesar XOR driver development, certainly much nicer to develop this here with PCI pass-through. They know this build. No surprise, try this again, because can't build the Mesar demos often enough. I really wonder why this failed, so I'm pretty sure I merged this plenty of times last month. But you see, you can't, there's always something to fix. You fix it and then you fix it again. Maybe I also didn't commit something because I found it's not yet most amazing enough. But yeah. Again, possibilities are endless with this PCI pass-through. From drivers to from regular gaming use, high performance workstation use, driver development, testing operating systems, your own hobby OS, Haiku, Dragonfly, your own microkernel or Plan 9, work, whatever you might into, and otherwise just regular user fun. And as you see from the compile time, never can have enough CPU cores, so probably need to build some more amazing stuff. So this build now. By the way, let's check the history for Xorg. Is it Xorg? No, it's X11 free glut. Let's check the history. Did I not recently Xorg proto cache updated? Whatever. Due to whatever magics that worked earlier, fixed free glut to compile twice, whatever. Some of this looks compile, some of it looks like a typo, but compile. So then GLX gears, finally we are hopefully here. Yeah, so GLX gears, not the most amazing performant benchmark. We could also actually use my GL Vulkan benchmark that we usually use otherwise. Actually, this is slightly funny. Why is it? Are we running with 74 hertz here for some strange? Yes, we run with 75 hertz. That is interesting. Usually we run with 60 hertz here, right? And does XRender, do we have? No, we don't have XRender. Also emerge this, so this becomes a much more emerged test system here. You see all this stuff working, obviously, and the Vulkan benchmarks would of course look more amazing than this bloody simple GLX gears, but we are not here for that demos. The problem is, for Vulkan we would maybe sit here another hour, because actually no, this could actually be in Mesar, but anyway, we can save this for another live stream. Ah, no, I don't want this bash. This bash is, need to still hack some variable expansion stuff with this new bash. Otherwise, our GCC wrapper variables empty. This is why I don't yet want to use this new bash. This comes from committing package updates early. I also slightly wonder why we have this resolution XRender. So it sees. I really wonder why it chooses this mode. So when it already got this mode, this, what? Ah, it needs output for, what is the output name? Ah, there's output name. Output name is output DVI D0. What is now mode? What? So only reuse two dishes. So yeah, this is smaller, and let's see, this should give us 60 hertz, I guess. What do we have here? 60 hertz, yeah, so now we get actually still, why does it show 60? No 60, okay, so this is of course vsynced unless we, what was, let's see, does it have indirect help stuff for stereo samples? How to disable vsync? Probably some GLX vsync. Also need German keyboard, not to get crazy. What is this, false off or something? Probably not this. Do you know anyone? Too many mices, that mice obviously. Let's see, and then next stop is of course running, too many keyboards. Next stop is of course running macOS, BOS and whatever in there. So, Mesa vsync off, disable vsync for GLX gear is exactly what we want, and vblank mode 0. Okay, let's see. Of course, why should it be something obvious like GLX vsync something? It is of course vblank mode equals 0. Nah, only reuse Unicode spaces or what? Command not found. Unicode spaces here. Default value of option vblank or written by environment. And what do we get now? 7000 something frames. Just as we wanted for the most amazing performance test. Not. And this is probably, it is a good time to end this live stream, not to overload you, especially as we still have the IT Bits news show of this week to come later tonight. Thank you so much for joining. I hope you learned something. We can already shut this down here, shut down H0, IOMMU, GPU, USB pass-through, you name it. I hope you learned something more useful than hacking batteries and stuff. And don't forget to share, like and subscribe for all the next videos to come, and support me here and motivate me to do even more. As you see, we could live stream more or less each day, just that I have the feeling people get slightly irritated and tired of 20 live streams. And again, shut down this Ryzen also later this year, but probably Q3 or Q4, depending on AMD with the availability. Shut down what have we running, not that we damage here. This is shut down. Then we probably can shut down this. And also later this year, more AMD high thread count stuff to come. And like Ryzen 3000 series with Zen 2. And then also even more high performance than this amazing 16 threads of execution. And I hope to see you soon for the next videos to come.